Closing bell, and the market continues to be in fine form. If you're looking at the large caps, mid caps not really their day. Anand, before we let you go, I mean, any final word of advice? We're of course getting more and more of the Q1 numbers. Anything that's crossed your radar where you felt a fresh investment is perhaps required?
Well, at this stage, it is most important not to get carried away with the euphoria that is there in the market and to stick with a strategy of what can deliver growth over the longer period. Obviously, this year is a write-off. I don't think you're going to see anything anywhere which will justify the numbers, but you are really looking at the next 2-3 years. And I think the strategy of staying with companies like telecom, IT, selective pharma, specialty chemicals, etc., probably remains the safest bet. And you know, if you keep staying focused on the earnings, at some stage there is some protection at least, because when the earnings do come back, at least you are not going to be holding on to companies which are not performing. So that's the general advice. Again, stick with the larger companies. The market has come up almost to the last peak, and therefore it is likely that you will see some profit taking. And at this stage, you don't want to be caught in illiquid counters, which is also what I guess the market is doing in not moving up the curve now in the small cap, mid cap, but focusing on the large cap. So I think the market has kind of learned its tricks, but the important thing is to keep focused on the longer term earnings growth.
Absolutely. Take that point. Always good talking to you, Anand. Thank you for taking out the time. Market perhaps is also focusing on exactly what our ticker is telling you about. 3:45, there's a big interview coming up with Adar Poonawalla. We will get to know more about that Oxford vaccine and sort of how perhaps India is going to look at it. So that's, of course, beyond the market, but very much within the market realm, something that you should watch out for. But right now, let me welcome in Mayuresh Joshi of William O'Neill to get some thoughts in as well. Mayuresh, thank you for joining in. I have to start off with some of the major financials. We've heard from Bajaj Finance. We will hear from Axis Bank later on. What's your current view on the stock?
So clearly, as Anuj was mentioning, first of all, afternoon, Surbhi. As Anuj was rightfully mentioning, I think what they mentioned in the con call is going to be extremely critical in terms of the performance going ahead. At this point of time, when you're probably looking at their entire breakup in terms of consumer durable loans, in terms of SME loans, and the exposure thereof, the moratorium definitely has come off. But what is the growth parameters that one is looking at, specifically in lieu of the second half recovery? I think that is one aspect that needs to be monitored very, very strongly. Now, they've done that in the past. Whether they'll be able to do that successfully with the database that they've got, with the cross-selling that is available to them within the existing database, I think that is something that will get alluded to in the call itself. On the other hand, I think valuations very, very lofty at this point of time, and there is a lot of uncertainty around. So I think the management commentary is something that will do the trick for the stock. A substantial move in the stock, in my opinion, has already taken place so far.
Okay. All right. That's Bajaj Finance. We will come back and try and squeeze in some more questions before market close. Back after the break.